Please will you be seated. I'd like to welcome you all here to St. George's this afternoon. And also I'd like to extend a welcome to those who are watching us live stream through the internet. It's lovely to have you with us as part of our service through that medium. But before we begin the funeral service, I'd just like to say to you that we have the government's track and trace scheme in operation. So if you'd like to use that, then as you go out on your right-hand side, you'll see a little sheet of paper you can put your name on. That's entirely voluntary, but if you want to use it, that's there for you. But the funeral service begins with some words from the Bible. The first words are from Jesus Christ himself. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet will they live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. We brought nothing into this world, and we can take nothing out. The Lord has given, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him should not perish, but may have eternal life. We meet this afternoon in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace, mercy, and peace be with you all. We've come here this afternoon to remember before God our dear sister Sue, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, and to commit her body to be buried, and to comfort one another in our grief. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And at this point, just before we come to the readings and the tributes, we'd like to play you our second piece of music. Our second piece of music is Sitting on the Dock of the Bay.
Watching the ship.
And I'd like to read to you now from the Bible. I'd like to read to you Psalm 23, which if you'd like to follow it, it's on the inside left hand of the service orders, the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I'd like to read to you, first of all, a tribute from Auntie Pat. I was 10 years old when my sister June came home from the hospital with a beautiful baby girl. She put her in my arms, and the bond only grew stronger. Together, we laughed, cried, got up to mischief. I called her Little Miss Bossy Boots, but we were always there for each other. When I married my husband, Paul, he was readily accepted by the family, but to Sue, he was Daddy Paul. When he walked her down the aisle to marry Eddie, he could not have been more proud. Sue, a niece who had so much love to give, she will always be part of our lives. God bless, love. Sleep tight. And I'd like to just put Sue's life in a little wider context. Sue was born in 1960 at Chapeltown Maternity Unit to her parents, June and Kex, and she was one of five with Richard, Angela, Christopher and Andrew. She spent her school days at Sunshine School, King Street School and Kirkbork Secondary School. At Kirkbork, she met her best friend, Amanda. After school, she started to work at the co-op. And after a few other jobs, she began her career at the post office. This was to be a career lasting for some three decades. She worked hard at her job. She rose to become a manager. As a driver, one year, she was awarded the Driver of the Year. In 2006, Sue married Eddie at St. George's Church in Cyprus. In marrying Eddie, Sue inherited five stepchildren, 12 step-grandchildren, and 2 step-great-grandchildren. She loved these children as her own, and she was loved and cared for by them. There was one occasion when Charlotte, as a 7-year-old, asked why she always shouted at Granddad. She explained that it was because he was a little bit hard of hearing. Charlotte replied, "Right, I'll call you my shouty grandma." Sue was also very close to her nieces and nephews and their children. She was particularly close to Poppy and Layla, describing Poppy as the baby she never had. Sue also loved baking, and when she was younger, traveling. You remember Sue as a lovely person, well respected by all who knew her, always well turned out. Obviously, I didn't know Sue, but the fact that as we were coming into church, the way was lined by you all. That tells me how much she meant to you. And also the fact that we're actually live streaming this service, there's so many people who couldn't be here because of the restrictions. Again, that is a form of a tribute to the kind of person that Sue was. But I wonder if you've come here this afternoon and you wonder about yourself. What happens to you when you get to this stage? Well, if you're wondering that, if you're wondering if there's any hope, I'd like you to look with me again at the 23rd Psalm. The 23rd Psalm says, "The Lord is my shepherd." Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd." It's the job of the shepherd to lead the sheep. And Jesus offered to lead us in our lives. And he leads us even at this point. If you look at the 23rd Psalm, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me." If Jesus is the good shepherd of our lives, this is not the end. We don't stay in the valley of the shadow of death. We pass through it. Jesus leads us through it. Where do we go to on the other side? Well, the end of the 23rd Psalm. "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Jesus, the good shepherd, leads us in our lives today. He leads us at this stage, and he leads us onwards to our heavenly home. So if you wonder if there's any hope for you, if you're looking for something for yourself, put your hand in the hand of the good shepherd. Let him lead you. Let him lead you now, into the future, when you get to this stage, and he will lead you beyond. Shall we pray? God of mercy, Lord of life, you have made us in your own image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Sue, for the grace and mercy she received from you, for all that was good in her life, for memories we treasure today. Lord God, your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on all who mourn, especially those who mourn Sue. Give them patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Heavenly Father, you are tender towards your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal the memories of hurt and failure. Give us the wisdom and grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth, to turn to Christ and follow in his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. And we close our prayers by saying together the words of the Lord's Prayer, which is again printed on the inside of the service sheets. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So please can I ask you to stand as we come to the commendation. Let us commend Susan Hogg to the mercy of God, our Maker, Redeemer, and Judge. O God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust Sue to your mercy. In the name of Jesus our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And the service in church closes at this point. The committal will be up at Jump Cemetery, and our closing piece of music is Nat King Cole, Unforgettable. Thank you.
Of you does things to me.